Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to our class. This chapter is chapter 14 in Oxford curriculum, but in our curriculum, national curriculum is the first chapter. The first chapter is sequences, or in Indonesia we call it barisan. Chapter 14 about sequences. After sequences, we learn about function and graph. But first, we learn about sequences. In this chapter, we learn about patterns on rule, Fibonacci number, Fibonacci sequence, term to term, and position to term. Next sub-chapter, we learn about arithmetic sequence. The end term, what is the end term of the sequence, and then common difference. Common difference between two consecutive number. Okay, the objective of this chapter is generate terms of linear sequences using term to term and position to term rule. And then find term to term and position to term rule of sequences, including spatial patterns. First of all, what is the sequences? Sequences is series of number that has a pattern. What is the pattern? The pattern is a rule to form the sequences. Okay. A series of number that has a pattern. What is the pattern? The pattern is a rule to form the sequence. Okay. This is Fibonacci. Fibonacci is a famous mathematician. There is a Fibonacci sequence or Fibonacci number. Fibonacci sequence can be found the next term. It can be found by added the two previous term. The next term can be found by added the two previous term. Look at the picture of the column. The picture of the shell, yeah. The basic Fibonacci number is 1. The next number is 1. The next number is the edit result of the two previous number. 1 added by 1 is 2. Okay. The next number is 3. We can be found by edit 1 and 2. 1 and 2. The result is 3. The next number is 5, can be found by 2 added by 3. The next number is 8, can be found by added 3 and 5. The next number is 13. 13 is can be found by added 5 and 8, and etc. And etc. Look at the pattern of this cell. 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34, 55, 89, and 144. This is the example of the Fibonacci number. Fibonacci number can be found by edit the two previous term. The first chapter, we learn about rule of sequence. Write down the next three numbers of the sequence. 6, 10, 14, and 18. If we want to know what is the next number, we have to find the difference or the rule. 6 to 4, 6 to 10, added by 4. 10 to 14, added by 4. 14 to 18, added by 4. So, the first next number is 18, added by 4 is 22. 22, added by 4 is 26. 26 added by 4 is 30. So the next three number is 22, 26, and 30. We can find the next number by finding the rule. The rule of the sequence is added by 4. Okay, the second example. The first term of a sequence is 5. The third to term rule is multiply by 2, then subtract 4. The first term is 5. The term to term rule is multiply by 2 if the number is A. A is multiply by 2, then subtract 4. Okay. The first term is 5. 5 multiplied by 2. Subtract 4. 5 multiplied by 2, 10. 10 subtract 4 is 6. Multiply by 2, minus 4. 6 multiplied by 2 is 12. 12 multiply subtract 4 is 8. Multiplied by 2 is 16. Minus 4 is 12. Well, multiply by 2 is 24. 24 minus 4 is 20. This is the sequence. 5, 6, 8, 12, and 20. An arithmetic sequence or linear sequence is a one in which the difference between two consecutive terms is the same each time. The difference between two consecutive terms. 6 to 4 added by 4. 4 is the difference between two consecutive terms. The first sequence is the example of arithmetic sequence because the difference between two consecutive terms is the same. Okay. This is the character of arithmetic sequence. The difference between two consecutive terms is the same. The second example is not a linear sequence or arithmetic sequence because the difference between two consecutive terms are not the same. For example, the first term and the second term. 5 to 6 added by 1, 6 to 8 added by 2, 8 to 12 added 4, 12 to 20 added 8 ya. Added 1, added 2, added 4, added 8. Because the difference between two consecutive terms is not the same, the second example is not a linear sequence.